during that, right? If I'm gonna ask questions though, they are a little bit more behavioral based. I really focus on working in a group or team-like setting. I wanna know about your experiences. You know, maybe it's a group project, a case study competition, something like that. I wanna know how you kind of handled that situation. I ask about customer service. So if you have worked in retail or you have worked at a restaurant or a bar, you know, I'm gonna go directly there. If you haven't, I'll talk to you about how you dealt with, you know, maybe you're a coach or maybe you're an umpire, how you dealt with like a difficult parent or, you know, a difficult situation where you had to kind of work with somebody to maybe calm them down in like a professional manner, and something along those lines I'll typically ask. And then I always leave a lot of time for the student at the end for an interview, or for questions. You know, I wanna hear, for me, I'm very interested to hear the type of questions you ask. I think it tells a lot about the person and their interest in the firm, and their interest in our conversation. So I try to leave, you know, a good, almost like 10 minutes at the end for you to ask questions and for us to have a conversation. Because I think that's really important. You know, for me, I think it helped me get a read on you, but I think it's also important for you guys. So I try to leave a lot of time, which means, you know, if we're looking at a half hour interview, I'm only like interviewing you for 20 minutes of that, right? So you know your resume.
I found like a problem that I was like, when I ask questions, like I find like the person, like the partner, the interviewer ends up doing like so much talking, and I'm just kind of sitting there, and it feels like, I know like you're told not to do that, so how do you kind of like...
So I guess I would be mindful of the questions you ask.
Right.
You know your audience. Mm-hmm. Try to make them maybe a little bit more specific.
Right.
To kind of get a response you're looking for. Yeah, they like to, I mean, people like to talk. I mean, especially at that level,
yeah.
I mean, ask a partner about how they got to where they are in their career. I mean, that's gonna be, you know, it's like 40 years of work they can talk about, right? So maybe that's not a question you wanna ask. Maybe you wanna be more specific. Hey, why did you start in public, go to private, and now you're in public again? Or, hey, I saw, you know, from your LinkedIn, you were at Ernst & Young, you know, what brought you to you know, Cohn Resnick now? So that's kind of a way to hear about their career, but a little bit more direct, to hopefully get kind of to that point. So just be mindful. And again, questions are something you can think about beforehand, right? There's something you can prepare beforehand. So just keep that in mind. But yeah, I mean, people like to talk. And usually, though, in those situations, if you have, you still have questions, they'll let you ask them. They're not going to, like, kick you out the door. So. Good. Any other questions? I just want to be mindful of the time. I know we have, like, 5. Probably should be starting to pack up. So, well, I can hang around for you guys here. Sorry over there. I guess I'm getting kicked out, but... you know, if you have any additional questions, you can certainly email me. I'm more than happy to spend some time on the phone or answer any follow-up questions that you have. But I appreciate you guys having me here. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We did. Victoria did it.
Yeah.